All right, hi there, everybody. Hope you're doing well. Now, last year at TNIS for our performance piece, we did George Ezra's Budapest, which was a whole lot of fun. We performed it at the parents' night and also at assembly, which was really cool. Now, this year, we're going to go real old school with a classic by old Lynyrd Skynyrd. So most of the mum and dads are going to know this, that's for sure. Right, so we're going to do a simplified version of it first, just for all the people who have been playing for a wee bit, or maybe a year or so. So first, there's only five chords, and the whole thing really is just D, C over C9, and G. So here is the D chord. Now, you guys are all going to be getting music for this as well, with it all written out and tabbed, but this is just a video lesson for the visual learners or people who want to do a little bit of holiday homework. So here we go. D, we're going to go do two strums on that, and then we're going to do a C9, which is just leaving this finger here, comes up, two of those, and then a G with a D in it, and we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. So it goes. Okay, now if you want to, you can put an accent in it and do it like this. More in line with the, which we'll get to later on. Okay, right, so that is the whole song. In the chorus where it goes, sweet home Alabama, where the skies are so blue. Sweet home Alabama, Lord, I'm coming home to you. And there's just two real quick chords here, which is an F major 7th and then an A minor. On the bass later on, we're going to be playing an F and E over that. So it goes, so that very last part of the chorus goes, Lord, I'm coming home to you. And then back to the verse. Okay, now for you intermediate people who want to do the other parts, we've got a D here, standard D, but we're going to pick it like this. And go backwards from the B, C9 again, and then G. Now there's a little hammer-on which goes, which is hammering on the second, hammering on the second, pull off, and there's also a little run-up layer on which goes, ooh, these round strings are hard, but you can cheat and do a slide. Right, when we get to the bit after the first lot of vocals, we get this cool little riff that comes in here. Remember, you guys are going to have this all in your music. Cool, so that's that part. Now, of course, over top of that, all these basic chords work over it as well, so when we play it, we'll be playing different parts. Now the cool little part, the best part is the chorus, and it's going like this. Whoops. That chord that comes in there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to chuck it on, and for the first verse play the beginner parts, and then I'll come in and do the advanced parts, and you should have all you need to learn the whole song. Remember, simple chords, D, C9, and G, F and A minor, and intermediate and advanced. Let's see it as it comes. Here we go.
Thank you.
Pretty reasonably easy. I'd definitely recommend you guys listen to the proper video on YouTube, which you'll have a link to in your email, hopefully, and have a play along with that because it'll sound a lot nicer. But there you go, that's a physical example. Looking forward to doing it with you next term. Awesome. Happy Easter, everybody.